VCR, party life. VCR, party life. VCR, party life.
At the end of the 20th century, a scientist saw a killer comet on its way. He filmed instructions for its destruction. But then was hit by a Winnebago. So his assistants Nick and Joe must search every corner of his drone for the cassette that is on the home. But in the meantime, they'll play the greatest hits they found.
VCR, party life. VCR, party life.
Hi, Melinda.
Welcome to VCR Party Live, the show where
we
watch 10,000 VHS tapes
every single night.
Every night, you only get to see part of it.
But we continue watching them after we shut this down. We just keep watching them.
Yeah, because we got to get through this. This is our job.
We show you the exciting ones, not the boring ones.
And we always like to kick off with what we call a found footage festival classic.
Let's kick off with it.
This is a video that is from the archives. It's been featured in our live show before. And I'm not sure which one. What was Patriotic Medley from?
Volume two or three.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's an early cut. And we played just a snippet from a video, the Hulk Hogan video, Real American. Mm-hmm. And I think we might have played some of this last 4th of July show too. But this one, I think we had it on VHS at one point. I don't know what happened to it, but I found out that on this DVD, Hulk Still Rules, they have this. It's kind of shiny there, but Hulk Still Rules. But remember Easter eggs?
Yeah.
It's not, I don't think they could legally put this on the DVD. So it's like you have to go over and hit next and then up on the third menu. It's got like
is
this.
Is it like, did you learn about it online?
Yeah.
Like somebody, okay.
Yeah, like on the, I used to go on those Easter egg sites, you know, and look
about
for the.
That. Yeah. Yeah.
And so anyway, this is hidden on disc one in the third chapter menu when you hit up. And it's Hulk Hogan's video for Real American. I thought we could watch as much as we can get through.
Yeah.
It starts off very dramatic, and this is for the 4th of July happening here in America.
Yeah.
So
we're definitely getting a YouTube copyright notice
100%.
On this one.
Yeah, we're just planning on it.
Yep. But there it is. It's worth it.
I am a real American.
That sounds like John Lennon.
Yeah. This isn't Hulk singing. That's a young Terry Hulk Hogan.
Oh, I can see it. Oh, he's always been cool.
Yep. Yeah.
His fingernails were longer than Hogan.
Comes crashing down. Oh, look at you thought he was down and out, and then he found reserves somewhere.
Two hands. Oh, big jump shot.
There's George Washington.
Our first wrestling president.
That's right.
Yeah.
American,
all wrestlers.
Respectful.
Yep.
Women's celebration. Vietnam War. And then here's Hulk.
He needs a statue.
Cowboy boots, too. Who were the American wrestlers? There's Hacksaw Jim Duggan was like all USA, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I think that... What do you mean, like, American?
Like,
who are, like, pro-America?
They would use patriotism as their gimmick.
He headbutted the Russian flag.
He headbutted the Soviet flag.
Oh, this is fun.
St. Louis Arch, with the bridge, feel the blue.
With like a combine coming right
Yeah,
forward.
Yeah. Look out, Hulk.
Steve's getting emotional over there. He's bawling right now. There goes a rocket to kill some people.
And then here's the Hulkster on his motorcycle.
Oh, that's how you kick off a show right here. Get everybody fired up.
They later, they kill Paul.
Take that.
Okay, it's Gaddafi.
Take that, Gaddafi.
No. And then he rips off his shirt. It's funny how wrestlers, they used to just look kind of like strong grandfathers. And then
they always look doughy.
Yeah, like, and then around the 80s when anabolic steroids became available, they got really strong, just happened to it. At the same
yeah.
time.
I feel like George Animal Steel, like he's what they all used
exactly.
to look
like.
Exactly. Kind of like chubby guys.
And then the rock and wrestling era. The Hulkster.
Yes.
Train, say your prayers, eat your vitamins, be true to yourself, true to your country, be a real American.
Wow. That's a positive message.
We watched the whole thing.
Kick off the show. Yeah. That's all 3 minutes of Hulk there.
Yeah.
But I thought that was good for the 4th of July. It's
exactly.
On Thursday, and it gets everybody in an American mood. So take that picture of Gaddafi you got and
crumple it up. Throw it on the ground.
Headbutt the Soviet flag.
Then tear off your shirt. check it out. Back there, we got the Garfield belt. The Garfield belt is officially up. It's decorated now. It's on here. And I know that I told people that I wanted to give it away. And then I rewatched the episode last week, and I was like, do I want to?
Well, see, and for those who didn't see last week, we're doing a new segment called Nice Things, and you showed off your Garfield belt, which was made by a prisoner that we found on the road.
And it's horsehair, too. And last weekend, I was telling some people the story, too, and they're like, oh, that's incredible. I want to see it sometime. And I was like, man, I don't know if I can...
But is it a bigger thing to give away a prized possession, you know? Like you said right
now,
it's hanging up in a back room.
It was just like hanging up in my closet.
Yeah.
Or like in a room that I never even went
into.
So we asked people to send in an essay about why they deserved it. And that's why I feel...
150-word essay.
That's why I feel guilty about saying... But I think I can give it up. I think I can give it up.
Yeah? Well, if the essay is good enough.
Well, this particular one's very good. It's from Deborah in Virginia.
And I read it today.
It came in today. I think it's our only one so far, right?
Yeah, it's the only entry into this.
I'll put this as a rule. I need more than one entry in order to give this thing away.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? I can't just, if there's no demand for it, you know?
Yeah.
And I'm not going to read the whole thing, but Deborah, very good writer, wrote a very clever letter. It was from the perspective of the bootleg Garfield belt.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll just read you a little bit. It said, "Dear Joe, the moment I saw you across the room where I was created by a Montana 20 to lifer with grizzled hands tattooed in ballpoint ink, I knew it was meant to be.
Oh.
You and your aquamarine Jamaica tank with the barbecue sauce stains." Do they show up?
Eerily
the stains
accurate.
Show up? "Crumbs in your beard, the glaze of day-old Pepsi hazing your eyes, Melinda muttering from your lips. At that moment, I needed you, your love, your support, and your inexplicable spare $250. Because, Joe, you merely adopted the prison gift shop lifestyle. I was born in it, molded by it."
Oh, because the belt is writing it.
Exactly. It's,
wow.
It's written from the perspective of the
So would you give the belt to itself?
Well, I have the address here. I have Deborah's address here. I mean, it's very well written, she definitely is deserving of it.
She makes a good case, yeah.
I just need to see more essays.
Because you did pay $250
exactly.
for that belt that doesn't fit, yeah.
What if I just sent up, like, a picture of it?
sure. That's in spirit with what we ask people to do.
Yeah.
Somebody asked me to try on the belt, so maybe at the end of the episode.
Oh, okay. It would probably fit you, actually.
Yeah, it might. Yeah. I don't know. But we'll see. That'll be a good test.
Yeah.
I might have to write my own essay if it fits.
Yeah. Well, it's very good, and it's about how I saved it from the prison.
But what we're saying is if somebody wants to be one, to be awarded the $250 Garfield belt made by a prisoner out of horsehair that we bought at a Montana prison.
Horsehair belts can only be made by prisoners. It's
right.
not worth it for anybody else to make horsehair belts unless you're like... It's the most tedious job in the world. Unless you like tedium, which, you know, I got some teddy bears out there who might actually like doing that.
If you're watching this for the first time, you have no idea what any of this means. But I'll just say that it's keeping in the spirit with the show, which is it's just a snake eating its own tail.
Yep.
As a further update, I have a video clip to show from a couple weeks ago. We played a clip from Who Needs a Movie as a Found Footage Festival classic. This is Fred and Sharon from British Columbia. We're advertising their services because they made videos.
Mm-hmm.
And I speculated, I wonder if they're still doing doing it. Turns out they have a very active YouTube page that gets a lot more views than we do.
I looked at it, and, and like they do like a reality show or something on there that you should definitely check out.
It's just a couple of older people, very nice people from British Columbia who learned how to do animation. And, well, let me just show you one of the videos. This one is called something about Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie. Mm. So it's dated, but yeah.
How many hits?
I think this one has a million. So, and I average about 100 people watch this show, so I don't know.
Hi, I'm Sharon Spencer. I'm a relationship expert from Kelowna, British Columbia, Canada.
Brad Pitt has been reported to be smoking hashish with Quentin Tarantino.
My advice, Angelina, count to 10. Brad, remember you are a role model to your children. Practice moderation.
I never lose my temper unless I'm hungry.
I think I will sleep on the couch tonight.
I hope Sharon doesn't lose her temper. Uh-oh, here she comes.
Uh-oh. So Sharon... Sharon rode a dragonfly into Fred. Had the dragonfly push him off his dragonfly, and then she...
We all saw it. We all saw it. All right. It was clear.
Didn't mean to recap. But God bless them. They're still at it. They're still making incredible work, and they're doing a lot better than we are. So well done.
I watched their reality show, and also like they're just like it's just like they saw the animation, and they're like, let's make animation. So then they made it. They're like, they must have seen a reality show. So they're like, let's make a reality show. So they made it, and this reality show has zero conflict in it, and it was Mother's Day, and they wanted to take Sharon out to breakfast,
right?
And they took her out for breakfast.
Had a nice brunch at
They had a lovely brunch, and everything went great. And I don't think they had the hits on that one though.
No,
was significantly fewer hits on that one. But everybody should check it out because it's really good.
Fred and Sharon's movies. Yeah.
Let's see. Oh, so George, people love George. Right?
Yeah, he's our resident VCR party historian and expert and editor, yeah.
I'll always just say the things and then you do the recaps.
Right, I'll do the heavy lifting. Don't worry about it.
I hate doing the recaps. So George, his claim to fame now, I feel like, is he tracked down Sister Sam by finding her VIN number. And
he's tracked down a lot of people from Found Footage Festival and from VCR Party, whether we want him to or not. He's this person passed away last year.
You know, he was doing it before we knew him, too. Like, I think, like a year ago when we didn't even know him, before he made the intro to the show.
Right. He just gets fascinated with the people in the videos like we do, but takes it way too far.
He found so much stuff about Melinda. You remember that? Yeah. Well, anyway, we're thinking of giving George his own corner. I think somebody suggested it in the comments of George's creepy corner.
Okay.
All K's. Creepy and corner, all with K's.
Oh, right, with the Clown Museum, yeah.
You want to recap that? Did you want to?
Yeah, so I was driving in Nebraska and I found a Clown Museum, but it's spelled K, Clown Museum.
So we're going to do that. So I want to give George his first mission. George is probably watching there from his like really dark room, like in a basement somewhere.
Yeah.
Smells musty in there.
Yeah.
With like his like phone book full of VIN numbers. And I'm going to, we played this last week, 2 weeks ago?
Yeah, last
week. I can't remember. It's potty time.
Oh, the potty training video.
With
the
Super Duper Pooper.
Right.
Yeah. So I'm just going to play it again. Because you can never see this video too many times.
Yay, Lizzie!
She is a super duper
pooper. I want to track down her.
Right?
Because she's probably an adult now.
Oh, yeah.
She can party with the best. No more diapers to get in her way.
Might as well track down him, too.
Sure.
We are very impressed.
He can track down them if he wants to.
She is a super
her.
Duper.
That's who I'm. That's who I'm. That's who I want to know. Yeah.
She knows when she has to go.
I think that would be an interesting thing. Like.
She's probably 38, I would guess.
Yeah.
She's the best pooper we know.
Yay! Now the party's about to begin. Come on, let's go.
He were less interested.
Yeah.
Right.
Well. I'll take what I can get.
Yeah, yeah.
But you know how George is. He's going to go above and beyond. He's
I do.
Gonna...
Sometimes I'll get updated and I'm like, you know, I think the better, less is better with that one. Like, we didn't need to know that this person had a sordid past. That's just funny to watch the pooper video.
So, all right, George, find That's the little girl mission? From the Super Duper Pooper. And we'll have him on next week.
And it'll if be it's the depressing, new... don't share it.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly. Or, no, actually, no, I'm fine with that. I'm fine with depressing.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's fine too.
I'm fine with bumming everybody out.
Okay. Do we want to talk about the Rejuvenique?
Oh yeah, yeah. Thing? So we were gonna play it, but then we just uploaded it last week, and we forgot to tell everybody about it. George put together a recap of all of our fun with the Rejuvenique face mask from the past year. From
this thing right here.
This thing right here, the Rejuvenique face mask. And we had competitions where we put it on our face, we zapped each other, and I put it on Nick's ass for my birthday, and zapped it a bunch of times. And George put together a compilation of all the fun we've had with the Rejuvenique.
Saga.
It's probably like 5 or 6 minutes long.
I think it is, yeah.
Yeah.
We found it at a Goodwill. It came with the video on how to use it.
And now we have like 15 of them.
Now we have a ton of them. But,
yeah.
Yeah, so watch that. That's on our website.
Yep.
And you can find it, right. Yeah, whatever you're watching this, that's on there.
All right, let's do a little show and tell action.
Okay, show and tell. And I think it's going to say special guest show and tell, or is that not even in there?
Yeah, it's not working.
Okay, show and tell.
It's show and tell time.
Do you want to go first or should I?
You go first, because I'm only doing two.
Okay.
I'm saving my third for the end song.
All right, let me start off with this video that a friend of mine sent in, and he works for CBS, and for some reason came across this news report from 1984 about the VCR revolution, the video revolution from 1984. And not hilarious, but I thought it was worth showing because it's what people were saying about VCRs in 1984.
Okay.
And some turned out to be true.
In this country,
I like the weather guy too. This is CBS Morning News.
Jane?
Thanks, like local
Steve.
Or like?
As part of our ongoing look at changing lifestyles in this country, we're about to switch live to a video cassette store in New York City, where Betty Ann Bowser is waiting to tell us about the video revolution, how video cassettes are affecting the lives of an awful lot of us. Betty Ann, good morning.
Good morning, Jane. I'm in a store called New Video in Greenwich Village here in New York City. 3 years ago, this store wasn't even here, but two young men who founded it had an idea. They had a limited amount of capital, and they thought, gee, what would happen if we rented video cassettes to the public? Well, today they have two stores
and
10,000 titles,
porno.
Which should tell you something about
10,
the video
titles,
revolution.
Which is what we have in here now.
Mm-hmm. Quality B-roll.
And our friends think this is the greatest thing around. You know, this is the most decadent thing that anyone could ever think about.
When stereo salesman John Deba has a rough day at the office, this is how he relaxes at his home in Santa Rosa, California, with one of his four video cassette recorders, or VCRs as they're called. Tonight it's the Muppet movie with his wife and three-year-old daughter, Dina.
Our daughter, Dina, she would amuse herself at all times just by putting a video cassette in. She'll sit there and watch a movie. 2 hours and not have peep out of her.
Like millions of other American families, the Divas have been swept up in the video revolution that is taking the power of the boob tube and putting it in its place. It's power to the people now. People deciding what they will watch and when they will watch it. In John Deba's case, it's where he will watch it as well.
Oh,
right.
Bomber of a tight end in Russ Francis,
number 81.
I mean,
you know, when we first went back in late 70s and then... It was a novelty to have such a thing. But now, I mean, we have one at our business, we have one in our car. I mean, it's part of our life, that's for sure.
10 million VCRs have been sold to date. And as their cost continues to decline, an estimated 15 million will have been sold by the end of this year. By 1987, one in every three households will own one. From the big city to the small town, VCRs are changing the way we live.
Jane?
When we come back, we'll get the lowdown on how people disappear in this country. The mystery of missing persons. Stay with us.
So that's right after the story about how the VCR is taking over. It's the video revolution.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like one out of three households did have a VCR by 1987.
We had a Toshiba.
Yeah?
Yeah.
We did too. We had a Beta first, and then we switched to a VHS VCR. And
What brand? Do you remember?
We had a Sony Beta, but I forget. I think a Panasonic, I think.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. I always remember being fascinated by it and thinking, why can't I just hit rewind and have it rewind back to like the 1920s and watch 1920s TV?
Like if you were recording television.
Well, I didn't know the I just knew that you popped it in, you could hit rewind.
Yeah.
I didn't understand the concept. I wasn't a very smart child.
Right, no, yeah.
But while you're watching the video, I was thinking, you just rewind it. Just keep going back to like the 1930s.
Yeah. And I had that same thing where I was kind of like, I didn't know how the machine worked, so I remember recording, I don't know, Webster or something.
Sounds right.
And then thinking I had to be quiet during it because otherwise it was going to pick up my sounds during Webster. So I would tell people, I would tell the family to be quiet and then realized eventually that it wouldn't pick up the sound.
But we were both stupid.
Really
dumb. Right? We were
really
both
dumb
really
kids.
Stupid.
Yeah. So welcome to the Video Revolution. We're kicking it off tonight.
Okay. I got a fun one. This one was sent to us. Hold on. Let me find it somewhere. Here it is. So this video, I'm just going to tell you the title right now. It's called Hidden Doorways. And Steve, I want you to get in on this too. Tell me, and people commenting too, tell me what you think this is. Hidden Doorways. Is it a religious thing? Like a religious video about like, you know.
That was my first thought.
Or is it, maybe it's a get rich quick? And if, let me hear, what do you think? What do you think Hidden Doorways is? Could it be a Hallmark movie perhaps?
I went with LSD.
LSD?
I'm going to say it's about Satanism.
Satanism?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. We'll just play it. And here is Hidden Doorways.
All right.
And the dude sent it to me on DVD, so I don't have the actual cover.
Okay, the original.
But, worth the wait.
Hi, thanks for purchasing our video, Hidden Doorways. I'm Tim Moss, and over the next several minutes, I'm going to show you how you can assemble your own hidden doorway and the best position to locate it in your home.
Oh, wow.
Actual hidden doorways.
And a while ago, I was presented with the problem of building a hidden doorway for a customer so they can hide their
valuables. That's what this whole video is about.
Wow.
And after much
I want to be a homeowner just to build a hidden doorway.
Me too.
And I'm standing in front of a hidden doorway. And you can see, it looks like a bookshelf, and it's usable as a bookshelf. And if you push around on it, it's not going to open up. And you can see the seams, everything's tight. There's just no way that you would know that it's a door. And the way you open it, as you just push in this spot here, I have the hinges on this side, push on this spot.
Yeah.
And it opens up. Now you notice that you have to put
an
amount of pressure to open it up. I'm pushing
now,
that closed now, and it's not opening. You got to exert some force to get it open.
To get to your heroin.
And once it is open, you can go into your hidden space. And this space can be very small or it can be very large, depending on what you want to keep hidden. Now take notice, this particular customer who was kind enough to let us use their home for this video wanted a gun collection to store. And they built a gun shelf on the inside and a shelf to stack all their pistols.
King England comes and tries to take.
And like I said earlier, you can make this as deep as you want it to go, or as shallow, just if you had a few jewels that you wanted to hide. Now that we've seen a finished hidden doorway, I want to show you how to build your own.
I'm fascinated by that.
He shows you the step-by-step
really?
Of how to do it. But at the end, I should have included the ending. He says, he goes, here's a phone number. If you have any questions about your hidden doorway, give me a call.
We should have called him.
I know. I should have included it. We could have called him, and we could ask him like, what are some of the things that people hide in the hidden door?
Right.
In the hidden doorways.
Guns and jewels. What else?
Yeah. Or like, what's some of the craziest stuff?
Yeah.
Steve, can you make a note of that? Like, I'm going to work on that this week.
I want to call a guy.
Or George, if you're George is probably watching.
Yeah.
George, remind me to get the phone number so that you can call the hidden doorways guy.
Could we make one here in the office, maybe? Like, build a false wall?
Yeah, it's all concrete, pretty much.
Well, what was the Denzel Washington movie, the Spike Lee, that involved a hidden doorway?
Inside Man, Inside Job.
Insider? No, I don't remember what it was. But, yeah, I've always been interested in that. My sister's house has one, actually. It's in the bedroom, in their closet, there's behind it, there's just like a little cubbyhole. Did you see that? And you slide open a thing and go in there, and you can stand in it, and it's a carpeted room, but they don't use it for anything.
Like a panic room.
Kind of, but I don't know what it was there for. But yeah, The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe, it's everybody's dream to have a hidden doorway.
I want to buy a house just to get a hidden doorway.
All right, this one should irritate some people. This is another video. I think we had a rap montage in
This is one of our first ones. Volume one. I think this is like, this is one of our very first ones ever.
I don't know if you've ever seen the whole thing, but Kathy Smith, we have like a million exercise videos by her. This is one she did while she was pregnant. So this is both the workout you can do while you're pregnant, and then it transitions to the postnatal workout. And that's great. Good for her, but they didn't need to do a rap. And so here's a bunch.
I'm excited to see this because I've only seen just a little bit from the montage. Yeah. So I'm excited to see the whole thing.
Sing along. Rap along.
Like the rap.
And sunglasses backwards hat.
Hey, I take my water, it's okay with me. Cause every day's a new center of gravity.
You'll get much more from your pelvic floor when you pass on the bagel into one more kale. Now let's visualize those big baby eyes and then still pick up to the number one bug.
The number one bug?
Now, before you continue, make sure that you can carry on a normal conversation without getting winded. This is our last
award. Right. Yeah, that was the Prego Shuffle. A lot of fun for everybody.
Oh, that was fun and funky.
Whew. Yeah, I'm just...
whenever I'd listen to rap music, like in high school, like that was my genre that I liked
pregnancy
in high school.
Pregnancy rap?
No, just regular rap. Yeah.
Oh, I see.
But, like, my dad would hear it, you know?
Yeah.
You know? Suburbs, and you know, my dad hears it and he just goes off of what he sees on TV, which is like, you know, Fred
Walk
and Barney or like or stuff like that. And so like he'd always do like the whenever
to
I'd
make
be
playing
but that's what she was doing. Exactly, do it to make me mad, but
right,
like, rap, and just lame it up. That's what she did. She lamed up
the show too. Let's move on quickly.
All right. This one. Oh, you know why? I should have read this thing. This dude, he's a really cool dude. Oh, I don't have it. The guy who gave us Hidden Doorways.
Yeah.
He's posting here. It's Sean.
It's sorry, Sean. Yeah, I had that. Sorry, Sean. I should have given you credit.
Sean May.
Okay, so he also has a YouTube page where he has a bunch of old toy commercials and stuff on there. I forgot what it's called. Sean, tell him what it's called because it's a super cool channel on YouTube. I don't know if he gave us this one too. No, he didn't give us this one. I think Greg gave us this one. Greg DeLiso.
Okay.
Yeah, this is a developing your psychic powers video. It's called Develop Your Psychic Powers. I think we might have it.
I think we might have this.
But
tape,
this he gave on DVD too.
Okay.
And it just looks like Tim and Eric. It's just like exactly what Tim and Eric.
Green screen. And,
everything. And then just like the cast and what they're doing. And it's
great.
It's perfect. And it's also, we can try to do this on each other because it's between two people. You're going to want to take off your hat for it.
Try to do psychic.
To hone like psychic abilities.
Great.
So take off your hat.
So try it at home too?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
sure.
Try it
Let's
at home.
Let's do it.
I think you need a partner for it though.
Okay.
So. Litany Burns.
In order to experience your own healing hands, let's try a simple exercise together.
Okay.
First, release excessive energy so that your hands are clear of all tensions. And relax your body. Visualize your spirit filling your body with energy and sending that energy down through your arms and into your hands and fingers.
Great job.
Now visualize the center of your forehead, your third eye or focal center, opening like a pathway outward. Place an open hand, palm facing you about 6 inches from your forehead.
Focus on your weak chin.
Close your eyes and see if you can sense the energy from your hand.
Put your hands together.
Is it radiating out or withdrawing?
Okay.
Or both?
Am I the kid?
Now place the second hand
in
front of your focal center and sense the energy. Do you notice any difference? If another person is present, practice preliminaries and each allow your spirits to fill your hands and fingers with healing energy. Now place a hand in front of the other person's focal center and sense the energy. Is it radiating out or withdrawing?
Do you seriously feel that?
Yeah, it's amazing.
Sense the other hands.
Okay.
Do you notice a difference?
Do you?
Wow.
Try this exercise several times during the next 2 days to notice any differences.
I thought she had a purse over her shoulder.
Okay, that's it. Wow. That's develop your psychic powers. I mean, that's Tim Narek's practice.
But yeah. Wow. Yeah.
No, but seriously, you could feel that?
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah. Yep. You feel good?
Feel great, yeah. My psychic powers are getting honed. What's my last one? It's a tape trading classic. Do you have the graphic for that? We got a graphic, everybody.
Tape trading classic.
Tape trading classic.
Mm-hmm.
George helped.
George does everything for the show.
I said, I want a Monty Python thing of a guy in a trench coat, you know, like a Terry Gilliam animation. He knocked it out of the park. Mm-hmm. He, like, at 4 a.m, I got an email with that, so... Thank you, George, for that intro. The reason we're doing a recurring segment is because we are, I guess, exposing a new generation or people who weren't part of this tape trading thing in the 80s and 90s, mm-hmm. where you trade around different footage. We're exposing them to some of the classics from the genre. This one is outtakes from Siskel and Ebert. Film reviewers who grew up watching and Ebert in the movies.
This is a classic.
I'd watch it every week, syndicated. And this is the reason why I love this one so much is, I mean, we've known each other since we were 10, and a lot of what we do is just snip at each other, basically.
Bust balls, yeah.
Yeah, and especially like on this show.
Right.
And this is basically two guys who've been broadcasting together for like 30 years talking. And then eventually they find a common enemy, though. So just watch this.
Wearing last week? No, this
it's not. Don't worry about it. Okay.
They're recording a promo.
Wearing a brown sweater. This is not the part that's supposed to match, Slick. Mm-hmm. Give it a moment's thought. What are we doing now? The promos. Mm-hmm. Do you know what they have to match? Nothing. No promo ever has to match anything.
I thought we were about to do...
Welcome to the exciting world of television. A wholly new field for you to begin to learn in.
Well spoken, Roger.
Well spoken, Roger.
That's something that you rarely hear.
Wait.
It's something that you rarely hear. It's like, I think Roger Ebert is the only film critic to ever win,
Pulitzer or something?
A Pulitzer, yeah. Okay. And here he's saying, like, just the most childish insult.
The promos. Mm-hmm. Do you know what they have to match? Nothing. No promo ever has to match anything.
I thought we were about to do...
Welcome to the exciting world of television. A wholly new field for you to begin to learn in.
Well spoken, Roger.
Well, that's something that you rarely hear. A compliment really paid to you. Gene Hackman and Kevin Costner in the Pentagon thriller, No Way Out.
That's this week on Siskel and Ebert. I think you're going to have to redo it because you're going to get flash frames with the speed with which he read across those stars and titles. You won't even you won't have a second and a half of it.
Fuming.
Okay,
fine.
Do it again, please.
Sound a little excited, Gene.
Sound less excited, Roger. That's why we're redoing it, because of what you did. It's Thriller Week on Siskel and Ebert at the movies, and we've got three new ones.
And the movies, not at the movies. And that's why we're doing it this time.
It's Thriller Week on Siskel and Ebert in the movies, and we've got three new ones.
Dennis Quaid in The Big Easy, Michael Caine in The Fourth Protocol, and Kevin Costner and Gene Hackman in No Way Out.
That's this week on Siskel and Ebert and the movies and the asshole.
Great. That was great.
And that's Roger. That's because of that's what that whole goddamn culture drinks to death.
Okay,
all those wasps.
Okay,
talking about wasps.
You know, they don't get enough shit, basically, wasps. They don't.
They don't. They're called yuppies now.
They run the goddamn country, and all of us, all of our... I'm speaking to everyone who's eavesdropping right now. All of us...
They don't run the whole goddamn country, Gene. What about the international bankers?
Oh, yeah.
Not to mention the Vatican.
No. I'm talking about they run...
And the commies!
No. They run the country. The WASPs run the country, and all of us should band together and overthrow them, and there could be...
You probably think our president is a WASP. You think our president is a WASP, don't you?
No, he's not a WASP.
Okay. He isn't, because he's Irish, so he's Celtic. You know that...
Yeah, but you know what I'm talking about. They're all Protestants. They've all been Protestants, you know
okay,
that.
Okay, we have to do this. Okay, here we go.
Come on, band together, people. Let's overthrow the country.
Protestants, people who sort of want a religion.
Here we go.
Let's stick together. The Catholics and the fucking Jews. We go back a few years together.
Come on.
Hey, listen.
We're real. We get down and get dirty.
We were burning each other when Martin Luther was only a gleam in his mother's eye.
I'll take a Baptist. I go back 6,000 years. Somebody that has some goddamn passion, some blood coursing through their veins.
Case closed.
Anything.
Right. Goddamn Protestants. Biggest thing that happens for them on Sunday is a bake sale.
No, they got to decide what color yellow to tie to fucking buy.
That's right.
Okay, gentlemen, we're going to have a
He's right.
Gee, what should it be, lime green or dark green today,
He's
honey?
Right, the only fucking religion that has the Reader's Digest is a prayer book.
They don't get enough shit, and they have all the money. They have all the money.
The only last
all those guys, they're all running Northern Trust. They have all the banks on LaSalle Street. It's all horseshit.
The only time Protestants get on their knees is to adjust the fucking TV set.
They have all the goddamn insurance companies. They have all the insurance companies. They run the government. They run everything.
You're right.
Okay, tape is rolling, and here we go. Stand by, please.
Found something they could agree on.
Steve Martin's new comedy, Roxanne.
This week on Siskel and Ebert and the movies.
There it is.
Oh,
classic.
Man.
I want
That's
more.
So good.
I want more. You could listen to them. They snip at each other, but then they still, they both hate Protestants, so they came together at the end. I miss those guys.
I do too.
I really do.
Yeah. Man. God, so I gotta watch that again. I really want to.
I'll put it up maybe as like a web clip this week, so you can watch part of it. Yeah.
No, but we talked about doing this Tape Trading Classics like show. Like,
yeah.
It just like its own show where we come out, we talk about all the classics that everybody should know about.
Yeah, I think we'll do it. We'll tour it, and then we'll make it a DVD. And because I think
and it'll be our chance, like really rail against the Protestants.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I think if nothing else, it's an excuse
like in
to
between
do that.
The clips. That's when we'll go off on the Protestants.
Right.
Yeah.
The WASP running the country.
Yeah.
Is that it for show
That's
and tell?
It. Close it up, Steve.
All right. Show and tell.
It's closed.
Now we got some updates for you for those diehards.
Okay. So Tape Boy, I had this on the list last week. I didn't bring it up. Tape Boy, there's an update on Tape Boy.
Oh, is Tape his Boy. Nose on?
He's, yeah. Been, no, I know. I'm
people
very
are gonna,
embarrassed.
Yeah. They mentioned it on the
news.
Yeah,
the
I know. I just, we get hollered
Add that
at
to
if
the
we
checklist,
don't.
Steve.
Yeah.
All right. Tape Boy's.
Will you do an apology corner for it?
Nah, why do I apologize for that? No.
Okay, so, because you're good at those.
Asshole. That's what go is.
So Kalen, I talked to Kalen. So I wanted to do it with real human teeth. Have I talked about this already? I feel like I might have talked about this. I wanted to do it with real human teeth and our hair.
Yeah.
And Kalen said it didn't
and
want
I
to
said,
do
And I said, why? That was my question.
Well, because I wanted it to be unique.
Right.
You know?
Okay.
But then, so then I went on to eBay a couple weeks ago to send Kalen some real human teeth. And you can buy human teeth. They're like $30. Like, you can buy a full mouth set.
Kalen's guy sent this in unsolicited, and now we're commissioning him to do others. Right. Yeah.
So I wanted to do it. So look at it. So look at the teeth on here. I thought they were real teeth on here before. But they're not. They're just fake. They're fake teeth.
Yeah.
And I thought, we can make it really unique. We'll have real hair. We'll have real teeth. Real teeth are hideous, and they're huge. They're way bigger than you think. Steve, I put up a graphic on there of like real human teeth on eBay, and I would have gladly paid $32 for them or whatever it costs.
Yeah.
But I just don't know how he's gonna attach that onto here. So
you have an understanding of teeth from like a Looney Tune that gets their teeth that crumbles out. Like they just end here. That's what you thought teeth were.
No, they just keep going.
Yeah, they go in.
And
a
they turn
bit.
Black apparently too. So.
Yeah.
We're not going to do real human teeth. We're not going to do real human hair. What he is going to do, he's going to do a bargain Bernie for this first one.
Great.
So it's going to be like, it's going to be Tape Boy's uncle or something.
Sure.
It's gonna be
his
like
uncle
family
bargain
member.
Bernie.
So it's going to be like a clown bargain Bernie.
Okay.
And I think he might make like pants that go up and down. So
oh,
can, like,
whoa.
Yeah.
All right.
Maybe I dreamt that. I don't know if he's actually going to do that, but I hope he does that. And then the one after that, he's going to do a rejuvenique where you remove the Rejuvenique off the face, and it's going to be a burned clown face.
Oh, whoa.
Yeah, so it's going to have a removable Rejuvenique. Whoa. Yeah, he's getting really ambitious with
this.
And
so the idea is we're going to auction these off in a sweepstakes.
Yeah, we're going to do a sweepstakes, and we already got some.
Yeah.
So do you have the address if people want to send in? Because this thing will probably be... This will be up in a couple weeks. I think he'll have it done in a few weeks.
I believe we got four in here. We got this one is a sweepstakes.
Yeah, VCR Party's Bullshit Sweepstakes Part 2. This time it's for a Tape Boy-like doll.
Yep.
Okay, so if you send it to
Cincinnati,
us.
Cincinnati, and then here's a two-part postcard.
There's only like, what, two?
Four.
Four or five?
Well, this is a two-parter.
But their strategy there was to have it in there twice.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
So that we have five so far. So if you send one in, like your odds are pretty good that you might get the Bargain Bernie Tape Boy's uncle... who's also a clown, but Bargain Bernie version of that.
Right.
You will be very likely to win it.
Okay.
So, and once, I don't know what to do with
once
Tape
again,
Boy.
we're overestimating people's interest in this. But if you want it, I think you got a pretty good. You got a one in five chance. Yeah, it is. Well, I had a quick update too. Wait, is that it for Tape Boy?
That's it for Tape Boy.
Okay. So this is interesting because. We talked about the Clown Doll Museum, and then we had my dad and Megan and Larry went, and they sent a postcard, and they said, "Hello, Melendez. Greetings from the 2019 Clown Festival. Wish you were here."
Oh, that was nice.
And then doesn't the dog on the front look like Marty? There's a little wooden dog there.
Okay.
Sort of. Yeah.
Okay.
I think it might be a seal, actually. Cool. But then, look at this. I haven't opened this yet, but this is from... Kareen Janovic from the Clown Museum.
I saw it was addressed to VKR Party.
Yeah. So I have not opened this, but it's to VKR Party, okay. And this is a response from the actual Clown Museum.
Handwritten.
"Dear Nick, Joe, and the Melendez at VKR Party,
yes.
By now your dad has communicated to you the status of your box of clowns. We are planning an expansion to the museum as we've outgrown our present building. As of now, we have not unpacked several boxes of clown dolls, clown with a K. I mistakenly thought your box had
been an order placed by
Vice President Julie to ready for the 2019 season of the museum and the festival. So, was very glad Dan came and your box was noted, and we do thank you and all your friends for your contributions to KDM.
Well, they're our Melindas. They're not necessarily our friends.
No.
I mean, she doesn't know.
We will have a shelf for all when the expansion is complete. So we will have our own shelf.
Great.
Hope you have a great summer and more discoveries. Kareen,
hot dog.
The president of the Clown Museum.
So we're starting to book shows for fall. We should just... Book a show for
Omaha
and Lincoln, so that we can go up there and time it with the opening of the expansion.
Oh, the expansion. Yeah. Well, I think it's years off, but
oh, really?
Yeah. It's still just an abandoned lot right now. But well, we could go there anyway and kind of put some pressure on them.
We could talk to them. Yeah.
But yeah. So that's the update from the Clown Doll Museum.
Mm-hmm.
Do we want to get into nice things, or what do we want
to
do now?
No, we got so much more to cover.
Really?
We have so many updates that we didn't update last week.
Yeah, you're right. We just kind of let it slide. So it was a full show last week.
So, let's see. The other thing, Nacho Chihuahua, the bonus episode. We did a bonus EP 2 weeks ago with Robert, the Nacho Chihuahua guy, so Nacho Chihuahua is this... look at me recapping.
I know, wow.
Nacho Chihuahua is the show that Robert is obsessed with. I met him at the Alamo Draft House. He says, I have, 27 copies of this?
Yeah.
He owns like every single copy of Nacho
Chihuahua.
Every
known copy of Nacho Chihuahua, except this one.
No, there's some more. He gave us this one. But there's some more online, but they're like $97 because he dictated the economy of Nacho Chihuahua. So it's a very rare video because of him.
Right.
So he knows everything about it. He tracked down everybody. We sat down, we watched the entire, all 32 minutes of it with him, hitting stop and pause and rewind constantly. The whole thing probably lasted an hour.
Yeah.
And he was like, oh, that person's dead now. Oh, that person now works at Sears. You know, he's just like, he knew everything about every single person. I'm just gonna show my favorite clip from Nacho Chihuahua.
And if you donate to Patreon at $10 level, all the back episodes are available, so you can watch us watch Nacho Chihuahua with Robert.
Which scene do you think I'm going to show from Nacho Chihuahua?
Is it the animals, the farm animals?
Nope.
Oh.
It's the scene where the old man eats the chip in a really weird way.
Yeah.
It's my favorite part. Watch how this man eats a chip. I mean, there's a lot going on in the scene.
Right.
And also, well, I'll talk about it later. All right. Watch. So here's a scene from Nacho Chihuahua.
They're always trembling.
There's a monkey on the bus, too, for some reason. Psst.
Never explain.
Nina, follow me.
A very homemade movie. Watch the way he eats a chip coming up here. Not there. Watch the close up. This one.
Oh! Oh, I hate that.
That is not how you eat a chip.
No. It's like a man.
He's got a cowboy hat.
Wow! Nacho, so quite.
Nacho loves chips, right?
Yep.
Come on, Amelia. Follow me.
Okay. All right.
I do like how they run.
So that's if you're at the $10 level on Patreon, we didn't announce it last week. We should have.
Yeah.
It's up. It's up.
It was a bonus surprise episode. Yeah.
There's even more good news. So Robert put out a DVD of it.
There it is.
And it's not $97. So you can own this. You can put it on your shelf. It's all the original artwork.
Wow, the packaging looks good.
Yeah, it looks really good. I don't know where you can get it. I think we're going to eventually sell it on our.
Well, I think NachoChihuahua.com, he made the website.
Yeah.
And so you can get it there.
You can probably get it there.
Yeah.
And I think we'll have the digital download eventually.
Oh,
but
great.
He included as bonus features our EP version.
Oh, the full episode?
The full episode. Okay. And then also he did a commentary track. He just told me the other day, he's like, I already made the DVD, but I also tracked down the owner of the monkey. or the son of the owner of the monkey.
Yeah.
It turns out she died. And I was like, what about the monkeys? Like, the monkey could still be alive because monkeys live to be like 35 years old or something like that. So it's
in this show and what we've done for the last 15 years of the Found Footage Festival is we find VHS tapes that nobody else cares about and lavish them with more attention than they probably deserve.
Right.
Now I see what our role is finding people who are even more specified than that, like George and Robert, and reining them in a little bit.
Yes, exactly.
Like making their obsessions palatable to the masses.
Yeah, that's right. And we have Ross too in St. Louis, who's also obsessed. So yeah, I mean, yeah, get in touch if you're obsessive, get in touch with us and we'll put you to work.
Yeah, we get a little support group where we exploit those people.
Yeah, we'll exploit the hell out of you. So Robert, Mr. Nacho Chihuahua, he said, hey dudes, I've enclosed a quick sketch of Nacho giving the finger and doing a kickflip over a VHS copy of Nacho Chihuahua, which is on fire. I hope you enjoy. So
wow.
I thought this was a nice thing.
Oh, that's great.
This is a nice thing.
Giving the finger, yeah.
Yeah, it says, yeah, boy, on the side.
See, I like getting mail. It's fun to just get
especially
things.
Especially like letters and
letters
like
and drawings.
And like,
yeah. Some of the decorated envelopes.
Like Deborah's essay. It was all handwritten on loose leaf. Yeah.
Got the best viewers. I also want to, is that it for Nacho Chihuahua?
Hold on, let me check.
Is that about does it for tacos?
What's that reference
it's a,
to?
A deep reference from a video about manners that we have.
Oh yeah, that about does it for tacos.
I want to talk about
that's
last...
That's how you should end the shows.
That's another one?
Yeah.
Okay, that's add that it. To the list.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. So last week, I think 2 weeks ago, we got a video sent in the mail called Elegant Napkin Folding, and it was about how to do napkin folds.
Yeah.
And then last week you played some of it, and they all had funny names, like the bishop's hat.
Yeah,
and
the tuxedo.
And there were ways to fold napkins in fancy ways at restaurants and stuff. So we asked people in the message boards to comment what their formal and informal names for a VCR party napkin fold would
be. I saw some funny ones in there, yeah.
And what I would like to do, I was actually sending some emails out today to people who specialize in napkins folding in the tri-state area.
What are you, George?
Yeah, I was channeling my inner George, and I want them to come in and actually make, like, we decide on what the official VCR party napkin fold is and have them come do it as a bonus.
Okay.
So here's some titles people chimed in with that I like. The Rewinder.
Mm-hmm.
Could be cool. Could be a VHS tape.
Oh, I can see that, yeah.
The Melinda.
Of course.
The Winnebago, based on...
Jack
Rebney video. The Rejuven Napkin.
Ooh!
Which
so
I
far,
really
so far
like.
That's my number one.
Yeah.
So far that's my favorite.
Wait,
are we giving a prize?
No, there's no prizes here.
Did we not say the prizes in that?
No, we did not.
Okay.
We just said don't donate.
We're just gonna.
Not everything has to be a sweepstakes. All right.
We don't want to run.
All right,
down
Roger.
Don't want to run down to the post office either.
The like, fast, yeah, exactly. Fast with class. That would be the formal napkin.
Oh, okay.
Fast
I like
with
that.
Class.
Yeah, yeah.
The baby rapper, but WRAPPER.
Ooh, we got a new leader.
The baby rapper.
That's my new favorite. Baby rapper. That's clever.
Clowning around with a clay with a K. That would be the informal
sure.
napkin
sure.
fold.
That's I like that.
The Anabin nap, like napkin.
Ooh, new favorite.
Based on a
new
Russian found Russian video.
You get it? He has it called Anabin WAP.
Didn't I do that one on live when we did this?
Oh, was that yours?
Maybe. Maybe.
Steve's
oh
in the
yeah.
Lead.
Maybe. Yeah. Maybe that was yours.
Steve's
yeah.
in the lead.
Maybe somebody was just
Anabin rap. I think I did, but
oh yeah, you did Anabin rap. WRAP.
Yeah.
I think. Yeah. This
oh,
was
Anabin nap is better.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah. Sorry, Steve.
Got him to the goal line. Someone else ran the yard. All right.
The Crazy Eddie indictment. It's based on a Crazy Eddie commercial.
Crazy Eddie indictment.
This one, the name isn't clever, but the what the fold would be is it's the Frank Pachowski, and this would be a napkin covered in peanut butter.
That's the front runner now. That's my new favorite.
This one is, I think, just more about how we would actually have a napkin. It's called The Bunched Up on Your Plate. This is an informal
napkin. That's a realistic one.
Yeah. This one's informal. Nick Nolte's pajama pants. I like that one a lot.
I can see that one like, folded over nicely.
And then this one, I just don't like at all. It's Nick's sexual napkin, which the word sexual napkin is disturbing to me.
Oh, I think
I
that's
just don't
great.
Think, yeah.
I like that one. Actually, that's front runner now. Next sexual napkin.
All right, I'm disqualifying that one.
Would it be like in the shape of like a wiener or something? Or like your wiener, maybe?
Don't ask me.
Maybe that... in the shape of your wiener.
No.
Okay.
But we, so we can... We can further discuss these, but I think we need to make a decision when the actual napkin folder gets in here, and we'll have them
do Nick's sexual napkin.
No, I think Anabin nap probably, but or the rejuvenapkin. Napkin. I think that's.
I can't decide.
Well, we could have them do multiple.
I love the Frank Pachowski just napkin covered
in slathering it peanut butter. Yeah,
it's not even a napkin
no.
anymore.
So
it's
we'll
a terrible napkin.
We'll have an update for this. We'll have if I can't find a napkin holder, George, we're putting you on.
Yeah,
right
George,
as well.
George
yeah.
will do it. George will look it up and figure out how to do it. What else are we gonna do? Oh, we're shooting an EP episode tonight after this.
Ooh.
And I've.
Oh boy.
What time is it? Okay. All right. And are we gonna upload it tonight too?
Or tomorrow morning. Yeah.
Ooh, excuse me.
The burps just keep getting grosser. People pointed that out last week. They're
yeah,
like,
somebody said like a
still of your burp.
Of my burp.
Yeah.
Yeah. It wasn't good. Yeah. I'm getting an allergy, a food allergy test pretty soon. I'm going to find out
Okay, I'm going to say beer might be on that list.
Yeah, I think you're 100% right. But here's a little, here's just to get you stoked about Adventures in Management. Now, we haven't actually done an EP that's tedious.
No.
Really. I feel like everything's just kind of like Memorial Day 2000.
Yeah, we haven't had a chance to even talk, really.
McSee and everything. Like, but Adventures in Management, it's fucking tedious.
And we had a vote. You guys voted this by, I think, like a wide margin of people wanted Adventures in Management.
My teddy bears are out there. They want it. They're hungry.
All right, let's watch
a
little bit
of I don't
of
think
this.
You've seen this, so I'm going to get you stoked for Adventures in Management.
Okay. Hi, I hope I didn't catch you just leaving for the day.
No, some of us gals are going out tonight, so
well, I hope you'll have a nice time.
Oh, thanks. Are you having
the
a
reason
problem?
I asked you, yeah, I'm having some problems, and I hate to complain, but one of the galley stewards is just causing me I just don't know what to do.
What animal does she remind you of on the left?
Yesterday I was doing lunchtime rounds with the doctors for the medicine team.
Mm-hmm.
And we went into a patient's room, and she's on an 800-calorie diet. She had ice cream, two cookies, a piece of bread, soup, juice, plus additional
fruit. This is Minnesota conflict resolution.
They looked at me
I hate to bother you, but...
I think you goofed, lady. I didn't know what to say. I was so embarrassed.
We'll see this later.
Good heavens. That means one of our galley stewards is slipping up,
turtle
doesn't
lady?
It?
Yeah, 100%
you know
turtle.
Who was in the galley the day
it's
before?
It's like the Tibby the Turtle
no,
drawing that you
there.
Could do to get into the art school.
Oh. Yeah, so here's the thing.
Wow, like, we're going to watch that whole video, huh?
I have no idea how long it is, and I feel like it's long.
It feels long when I remember it being like thinking it was like 2 hours.
Yeah.
So we'll see. We'll do at least, we'll do as
Steve
far as we can go.
Stick around afterwards too. So,
oh, no.
Apologies in advance.
Poor guy,
on
he's
that
got
one.
A real job to
it's
go to.
It's really
in the morning.
Boring too. Like it's all just like reenactments of like workplace
disagreements. Oh, we could go to some deep places then with what we end up talking about.
Yeah.
My thought is we
I'm gonna have to get drunk for this one.
My thought was we'd talk about managers we've had at previous jobs because it's adventures in management.
Okay.
But that's 5 minutes in, I'll have run out of managers to talk about.
Maybe we could just be quiet for the whole thing and just like, you know.
Sure.
I'd be fine with that.
Just kind of a peaceful.
I was going to say maybe take a nap during it.
Sure. Yeah. We'll just all watch you get drunk.
Yeah.
which is basically what VCR party is every week.
It is,
anyway.
Yeah, yeah.
Do we want to get into nice things or? Oh, yeah. No, we're still not there yet.
No, we still got a lot to go.
So we also played we played Totally Tulip, which was for Tulip Paints, the sweatshirt painting. There's this catchy song called that opens the how-to video mm-hmm. called Totally Tulip. And we asked Reese, our Australian jingle singer, to sing a rendition of Totally Tulip. Reese delivered. So here's Reese singing Totally Tulip.
Do you have a version of Totally Tulip for reference?
No.
Oh.
Feeling tulip, totally tulip. Feeling tulip, totally tulip. Doing my thing, it's plain to see. Tulip paint lets me be me. Fast and fun, that's my style. Feeling tulip, totally tulip.
All right, there's
feeling tulip, totally tulip. Feeling tulip, totally tulip. Happy tulip colors
keeps going.
Make me feel like dancing, playing in the sunlight, dancing in the moonlight, swirling, shining colors, colors all around me, rainbow shining brightly. Happy tulip colors. Happy tulip colors make me feel like dancing,
wow,
playing in the sunlight, dancing in the moonlight,
really underscores
swirling, shining
how little
colors,
the lyrics make
colors
sense.
All around me, rainbow shining brightly. Happy tulip colors. Feeling tulip, totally tulip. Feeling
giving
tulip.
It some, then it cut off. But yeah, that was Reese. So he delivered.
He's
God
great.
Bless him,
man. That's fantastic.
Yeah,
yeah.
But we he initially was singing jingles, and we got a new jingle. It's kind of a song parody. This one was sent in by. Oh, he sent in a bunch of stuff. Judah, what else did he give us? Oh, he gave us Wet Pets. WETPETSW. So this one is also from the Bay Area. And I think this one has some soul. I think you're going to like it.
I don't think I've seen this one.
I'm a credit man. That's I'm a credit man. So I think it was respectful of the original song.
I thought it was, yeah.
Well, I was going to ask people in the comments what, if there was ever a song like from a commercial that was like, where you knew that song from the commercial, the parody version,
before
the actual song.
Yeah.
There's a bunch that I can remember that are like that, but I can't quite think of one.
This is dedicated. What's the Betty Crocker one? This is dedicated to the one I love. I always thought that was Betty Crocker first, then I heard the actual song.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, there was a song before the Betty Crocker commercial.
I feel like there's a Bounce detergent one too that I
Bounced. There was one for CBS. Come on, baby, on CBS.
Oh yeah,
I'm singing totally.
I remember up, Dubuque Hams too.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Was
yeah.
Dubuque,
mm-hmm.
La Dubuque, mm-hmm. And I heard that before I heard the original song. So put those in the comments. I would be curious.
Yeah, I'm gonna
about
be
that.
Thinking about this tonight.
Yeah.
I know that there's a bunch actually.
Yeah,
yeah. All right, what else we got? Diamond Center commercial.
Do you want to get into nice things?
Let's
now?
Do nice things. Let's
okay,
do it.
Nice
yeah,
things.
We got to wrap things up.
You got the intro
here.
There?
We got a long night.
Yeah, we do. We're just getting started.
All right. We got Adventures in Management.
Adventures in Management ahead. You voted it in.
All right, so we separate into your nice things and I have nice things.
My tape's already in, so do you want me to start?
Yeah, go for it.
Okay, so the first thing is, I was up late one night and I was thinking about how there's a place in my neighborhood in Queens called Just Things, and it's like a thrift store.
I know that place.
Sort of curated, and at one point they had a Young and the Restless cast and crew jacket, satin black jacket. And it was like $45, and I was like, I can't do it.
And it's near the studios, too, right? So I wonder if they got a lot of their stuff
from
the studios.
It could be, yeah. There's a lot of the movie studios in my neighborhood.
Yeah, the studios are all over there.
And then I didn't pull the trigger on it, and I went back, and it was gone. And it was one of the biggest regrets of my life. It was my Garfield belt.
That
but
you didn't get.
I couldn't call back. I talked to the woman. She's like, I remember it. You should have bought it. And I didn't. So I was kind of looking up cast and crew jackets because I just thought they're funny. I mean, because they're always like dumb shows usually, but the cast and crew had to be proud of them. And when I worked at Letterman, we got one every year and stuff. But then what do you do with them afterwards? Well, somehow late at night, it got me onto a Dr. Quinn Medicine Woman jean jacket that was for the crew. And I was like, how funny would, if I had all the money in the world, I would just buy all these. It was like $300.
Oh, was it? Oh,
yeah. So yeah. I didn't buy that. But then it had a suggested item, and it was a Dr. Quinn Medicine Woman hat. More affordable. They had buy it now for $15. And I sent it out to a few people, and then I'm like, I just got to pull the trigger on this.
Oh, for sure. $15?
So I did a buy it now. And
here good color,
is
too.
Dr. Quinn Medicine Woman third annual golf tournament.
Wow.
It is so specific.
That's the most specific hat.
And there was another one. There's a red one that's still on there if anyone's interested. But
the font. Oh, is that that's embroidered on there?
It's
too,
embroidered,
isn't it?
Wow. Yeah. So
that's teal too, isn't it? That's,
they had a golf tournament for Dr. Quinn Medicine Woman. And this is the third annual.
Do you think they still do it?
Yeah, probably. All the guys get together. Yeah, the gaffers and they tell some stories about Dr. Quinn from the trenches, you know, and
have you ever seen an entire episode?
Not a chance.
Have you seen like 30 seconds of an episode?
Probably, probably flipping by.
Uh-huh.
So that was one thing. The other
thing. That is definitely a nice thing.
Yes. So the other thing is I Airbnb my place, and I had a French family in, and their 13-year-old was, he wanted to meet me. He liked all the decor in the apartment, and in the end, he made me a drawing that had all this like all this retro 80s stuff on it. And he got me some Mad Magazine cards. These were Mad Magazine cards. And I was like, oh, wow, this guy knows me so well. And then I looked, and it was on the back, they have a fold-in, and it's VHS-related. Just happened to be VHS-related. This is a sealed pack, but it says, what safe, cheap Star Wars technology would we like to suggest to the Pentagon? And if you put it together, it says, rent the tape, and it makes a VHS tape. So in other words, I'm not gonna explain it, but
I wasn't really listening.
Rent the tape. So that was cool. Al Jaffe's take on the Star Wars thing. Now the other things we were sent in, and I put together a couple. The first one is,
I want me and Steve and I, we should rent out Nick's Airbnb sometime.
Yeah,
we should.
You're
just
welcome.
Like,
sure,
like
come on by.
There.
Yeah. So Paige from Ann Arbor said she was driving by her neighbor's house and saw this elf thing next to the goose and the stuff in the lawn.
It's a nice thing.
And like a scarecrow, but a scare elf. And I thought that was appropriate. We all know Willie Tanner, Max Wright died.
Oh, that's right.
Kind of in mourning still. And then this was sent in by, I believe, Eric, who saw our Peppermint Park Letter M video. And I guess he had that video or something because he made a comic about it a year ago. And he's saying mayonnaise, medicine, monsters, no mayonnaise, whatever.
That's
and
a great drawing of the M singer.
It's a horrible puppet.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then that fox is making a comment. What kind of messed up song is this? This one, I love this one. Jeff sent this in, and he used to work at a Kmart in California. And this is designs for props they needed for a Batman costume.
Mm-hmm.
So somebody drew this. And then this was the back. Well, this is the back. Here's the front of the document. Settlement Agreement Exhibit 2. We've been in settlement meetings. They're boring as hell, so why not come up with some Batman plans?
Wait a second. So, do you think that that was the settlement agreement? Exhibit two? Like, do you think that that was, like, the Batman stuff?
Yeah,
like,
that he got all the Batman stuff in the settlement?
Yeah.
No, I think he was bored and was doodling during the settlement meeting. Legal meetings are boring. So those are my nice things sent in by some folks over the
week. Some very nice things. Yeah. Let's see, I got some nice things. So Jason in Denver sent me this one. He had an old tape, and he found this local O.J. Simpson commercial from Los Angeles for a fast food restaurant called Pioneer.
Okay.
You ever heard of it before?
No.
I looked them up. They're all gone except for one. There's one Pioneer left. So, this one, it's an O.J. disgraced.
No, I don't.
What's your hurry?
Gee, officer, I didn't want to miss Pioneer's anniversary special.
Ah, likely story.
No, really. You get two pieces of Pioneer chicken, mashed potatoes and gravy, a buttermilk biscuit, and a 12-ounce Pepsi for just $1.59.
Great, OJ. How about an autograph?
You bet.
Just sign the bottom of this ticket.
British America loves best. Pioneer.
Ooh, I like
from
that.
OJ. Pioneer's anniversary special is too good
to pass
up.
The police there.
He did, yeah. He didn't make a slow getaway. He just made a...
Yep. Some foresight there.
He was just eating
that Pioneer. Oh, so then Jason said, he goes, so he had that. He also has this movie that he got from a guy who I think made the movie, but the guy died, and he says that nobody's seen this movie except for Jason and the guy, but the guy's dead.
Okay.
So this is the cover. He showed me the cover. He's going to send it.
Wow.
And the Lebo.
The Lebo. It looks like some special effects. Are those pigs?
Yep.
Okay.
Yep. That's all you're getting. All
right. We haven't seen them.
It's in the mail. Okay. Or it should be here at some point. We'll watch the Lebo.
Oh, the only known copy of that.
Yeah.
Great.
Just like the guy who made it is dead.
Wow.
And like, it's the only known copy.
Thank you, Jason.
That's coming. What else do I want to show? Oh, this is a nice thing. My buddy Troy from high school, he has this new collection where he goes to thrift stores and he pops out the SD cards out of cameras.
Yeah.
And he brings them back, and he downloads all of them, and he has all these photos of SD cards.
That's great.
And so I'm just going to show you just a quick montage. He's been sending them to me all week, but I'm going to show you some of my favorites here. There's that one. And then there's that one.
Great.
Yep. And then...
you're ready to do a pregnancy wrap. Another one.
Boondock Saint poster.
Oh, cool.
Yep. Empty beer cans down there.
Bud Light. Yep.
There's that guy. What's on his ears? Wrestling?
I don't know.
Is that one? I cut off the guy's face a little bit.
Yeah.
But more empty beer cans back there.
Oh, yeah. Habsburg ribbon.
Yep. Christmas Day, 2005.
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
Great. Let me know what day that was taken.
There's a cat that doesn't look comfortable. So.
Wow. That's quite the collection.
Yeah, that's it for nice things.
Troy, thank you for doing that. Troy also, he spends a lot of time in thrift stores buying like old weird video equipment and old instruments, and he's a musician.
He's
so.
Definitely an appreciator of nice things, and he's a truck driver.
That's right. Yeah. Troy is fascinating.
Yeah.
Yeah. But that should inspire other people to go eject the SD cards from cameras at thrift stores.
Okay, we got unboxings to do, or should we get out? We got to watch this goddamn adventure.
I know, but I feel like we got to open these. Let's just do it.
Okay. Just very quickly. Very quickly. Christmas morning. Okay. This one's from Ross.
Like
from Ross.
Like it's
St.
Christmas
Louis.
Morning 2005. Yeah. Let's just...
Okay, oh, look at what he got. He got Sister Sam's CD.
Sam. This is based on George's intel.
We still gotta call her.
Call her. We have her phone number.
Yeah.
But we want to go meet her. She lives in Ohio, so we have to arrange a time to go meet her.
Yeah, when are we going to be there? We should get a scheduled show. But this is her CD.
But she's a country artist, right?
Yeah.
We found out?
Yeah.
Okay. Wow, okay. Oh, here's, this is from Will Pfeiffer, whose daughter posed in front of Harkness Insurance, another jingle we found.
Oh, wait. Okay, I remember that.
Allison. Hope these kind of find a home in the vast archives. Hope to see the live version in Madison, Wisconsin before too long. I think he's from Rockford.
Okay. Oh, yeah, that's where Harkness is from.
Yeah, we got Quigley's Village. That looks pretty good. A lot of deer hunting videos.
Oh, look at this. Okay. Cephas sent this one.
Oh, yeah, that's Megan and Larry who went to the...
And it's all clown. It's clown shit. Yeah, but it's not... look at this. Plainview, Nebraska's clown capital, two hats.
I'm going to let you have... That's two hats now, and a clown nose?
Yeah.
Wow, guys.
Oh, and a can koozie. Yes.
Holy cow, thank you so much.
And there's something inside the can koozie. Chi healths. Okay. Some Chi Health's first aid kits.
Great. Some first
stickers,
aid kits.
A tiny little, what would you even do with this? Would you play with this?
A frisbee? A mini frisbee?
A
yeah,
frisbee.
I don't know.
Regular size frisbee. Oh, so much good stuff. Thank you. I'm going to wear that. Wear this hat for the Adventures in Management.
Okay, this is from Mickey, our friend in New Jersey. He and his wife watch every week.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
Yes, that's right.
You went over to their place, right?
I went over to his place, yeah. He told me, his wife is Lisa Ann.
Right.
Yeah.
Who's always in the comments.
Yeah, she's a top fan.
Yeah. Everyone hates the way I cut this.
Yeah,
just,
I don't like
just
it
relax.
Either. No, it makes me nervous. Like, look at, you're going to slice me. Here.
Oh, wow, VCR games.
There
yes. Okay, here we go.
Oh, yeah. Here, use that on that side.
Wait,
so
I got
you open it.
Here, you read this.
Okay, this is from Mickey. Enjoy these nice things. Just a suggestion, maybe do some bonus shows where you guys try to play your VHS games. Let's do that.
Yeah, we've talked about doing Nightmare
yes.
for Halloween.
Yes.
Here's the original cool. box, which All we've right. lost, of Rich Little's VCR games.
Yes.
That's the Charades game. Doorways to Adventure, sort of the Indiana Jones style.
I want to do the Rich Little one. I think we should play the Rich okay. Little game. Maybe that could be a good EP mode or something.
This one would be good for football season. VCR quarterback.
Yeah.
And yeah. He goes, I know you guys like found photos too. Look at this.
Ooh. Yeah. Oh,
there's
boy.
So much to unpack
oh,
here.
Oh boy, yeah, there's a
There's
lot.
A grandfather kissing a little boy or girl on the lips. Mickey Mouse and then a this parent is, behind it.
This is getting framed.
Blown up to 8x10.
Oh, this is getting framed.
And we should have Mickey sign it.
Yeah.
Wow.
Well, which Mickey?
Oh, yeah. Well, that's a good question. We could bring it to Disney, too.
Here's what I'm going to suggest. Yeah. So, his suggestion of doing the bonus episode.
Yeah.
We play Rich Little's Charades games, but we play it with Rejuvenique's so that if we get something wrong, we get zapped.
Okay.
So we have more like, yeah. And maybe Steve can play, too.
Could we play? Could we, like, do we have a friend who actually does impressions that could be part of this?
Funny man.
Funny man, Steve Hyden.
Steve Hyden? Yeah.
If he's coming out anytime soon.
All right, well, we got our marching orders here.
Okay.
Thank you so much for all the gifts.
Wait, there's this one too. Do we want to? Okay, this one's heavy.
Okay.
This one's from, Bob. Bob Hedges.
People love how your hat matches the Rejuvenique.
Oh, yeah, it's sort of the same color blue.
All right, Bob hooked this up here. This is a heavy one. There's a lot of. Holy, wow. See, you know
and
what he, I love about them?
And there's post-it notes on all of them as well.
Wait. Nick, hearing you talk about McDonald's made me get you this. It's Asian sizing, so I hope it fits, Bob.
I hope it fits. I don't know if this bodes well, Bob, but, it's a shirt with a Big Mac on it?
Oh, that looks like a nice thing.
It's a Big Mac.
Will you wear that for the Adventures in Management
sure,
screening?
Sure, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, so stay tuned, donate $10, and tomorrow you can see...
That's getting me hungry. It honestly is.
It's got some Texas Original hot sauce.
I bet I'm allergic to most of the things on there.
I'll wear this with the Garfield belt and the Dr. Quinn.
Oh, look at a Shoji Tabuchi that I've never seen
Whoa,
before.
Whoa, no, that's volume
yes.
four.
I thought we had all the Shoji Tabuchis, and along comes this one. Thank you, Bob. He's, so much stuff in here. SpongeBob Magic, I actually want to watch it. Monster Truck, still
bloopers.
In the shrink, but
bloopers.
Definitely excitement. Yes, oh, Bloopers 3, Bicycle Safety Camp.
Wait, is it another Stripogram? Yes, there is a female version.
What?
This is a sort of Sally Kellerman looking.
Where does he get these?
Video stripogram.
Tips for management.
Wow, it's a happy birthday. So next birthday in the VCR party family.
Oh.
Yeah?
Hooters and merchandise, a profitable pair. Tips for management and staff, a Hooters
Whoa,
training video.
A Hooters training video?
A Hooters training video. That's going to be on next week for sure.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah, I should mention before we go here, that next week is an all sex education episode. We have our friend Kendall, who's a sex educator, coming in, and she's gonna watch sex ed videos with
yeah.
us for the whole time, for
I,
the whole hour.
I can't
hour.
Wait for
it's
that.
It's gonna be great.
Because you're gonna be so sexual during that, aren't you? Because you're a very
well,
sexual
by
man.
Default, no, I'm not, but by default, I'll have to be for this episode.
But you're like on the on the higher end of sexuality, wouldn't you say? Like you're, no, I wouldn't. You have an appetite, you have a thirst.
Yeah, that's what it is. Yeah.
A Hooters training video. That's going to be on next week for sure.
All right.
All right, we're going to leave you with this. God damn, I'm shaking.
It's a full show. This is a
it's
hell
so
of an episode.
It's so hard to get the training videos. It's really hard to get the training videos, especially a Hooters training
We got to ask Bob where he got that.
All right.
He does a lot of thrifting, I think, in Minnesota.
Yeah, I know, but still, I feel like we don't come across thrift stores that have that good of
stuff.
I wonder
he
where
must,
he's going.
Yeah, he must have some good spots.
All right, we're going to leave you with this. So this Friday, or this weekend, Nick and I are going to the memorial for Larry Pierce, the guy, the dirty country music singer, who we did a documentary about. The movie's called Dirty Country. It's his memorial. He wanted to do it over 4th of July.
Because we would always go there, and the band who befriended him would always go to his place in Indiana.
He had a big to-do for 4th of July, and everybody would come out. Yeah. Everybody in town, they'd light up these fireworks. Somebody would always get hurt.
Pipe bombs.
They'd bring in like actual dynamite for their like fireworks. Anyway, it's a big thing. It's happening this weekend. I put together a music video as a tribute that I'm going to play this weekend. I thought we would end with this.
That was a nice...
This is Larry's music video. It's called She Makes My Peter Stand Up. And it's not his grossest song. It's definitely gross, but it's about his wife. And it's a very loving song and about how she makes his Peter stand up. So
it's very nice. We're going to see his wife this weekend.
Yep.
So, yeah.
So, this is the live concert video, and I mixed in some photos of he and Sandy together. So,
it's nice.
All right, that's all that's it.
That's all that's
What's the other new thing that
we'll
you're
going to
say?
We'll be right back right after that.
No, there's a new thing tonight. Oh, Steve, did you write it down?
It was about tacos. No, I didn't write it down.
Oh, yeah. And that about does it for tacos.
All right, that's all that's it. See you next week.
What's the matter? He goes, come here and listen to this.
Let me tell you all a story about a girl that makes me horny. It's true. When I get this strange sensation, I can't stop this strong temptation to screw. She makes my Peter stand up. She makes my Peter stand up. When she looks into my eyes, in my pants I feel the rise. She makes my Peter stand up. When she's wearing tight blue jeans and they're pulling at the seams, I go crazy. When she bends over for a glass and her shorts right up her ass, my eyes get hazy. And when she's lying in the sun and the sweat rolls off her buns, the way she smiles, the way she sits, the way she shakes her little tits, the way she wiggles when she walks, make me want to eat her box. She makes my Peter stand up. She makes my Peter stand up. When she looks into my eyes, in my pants I feel the rise. She makes my Peter stand up. Now if you get the wrong impression, let me make this short confession, I can't lie. I wanna tell you right up front that this sexy little cunt is my wife. And when she's starting on the rag and my nuts begin to sag, she's wanting true romance, I keep my pecker in my pants, till I know that in another day or two she'll make my Peter stand up. She makes my Peter stand up. She makes my Peter stand up.